Hello friends, this is Yogesh Muramkar. In this video, we are going to talk about views. We are going to talk about different types of views and different operations which can be done on views. So what is view? View is actually a logical table which does not require any storage space. That is the difference between view and a table. Table requires storage space. So basically, we are going to talk about this particular statement. Execute different DDL statements which demonstrate the use of view and try to update base table using its corresponding view and see the changes. Okay, and we are going to talk about restrictions on those updatable tables. So I am already connected to MySQL database here. So let us check which are the databases available. So these are the databases available. Now I am going to use my database, that is MyDB, in which I have created some tables. Sorry. So if I type show tables, these are the tables which are already created in the database MyDB. So I am going to use different tables out of those. For example, we are going to use EMP table. Okay. So let us check the data in EMP table. So select star from EMP. Then check the data from DPT table. So select star from DPT is going to show you these data. So 13 rows in EMP and 4 rows in DPT, that is department table. So the first question on views is, create a simple view, my view 1, as my view 1 on EMP table. So the syntax to create a view is create view name. It is not actually select, we want to create a view. So create view name. So create view name is my view 1, and on which table you want to create? We want to create it on EMP table. So create view my view 1 as select star from EMP. So there will be a view created with the name my view 1 on the table EMP, which will be having all the columns and rows from EMP table. So if I type now select star from that view, that is select star from my view 1, so you will see same data which was present in EMP table earlier. So we have created a view my view 1 which is exactly a same copy, which is exactly a copy of the table EMP. See, 13 rows. Okay, so that's a simple view, example of simple view. The simple view is what? Which is created on single table. Next one is create view my view 2 with 3 fields. Okay, so the number of fields also we can restrict. In earlier query, we have created a view on all the fields. Now we are creating a view on limited number of fields from EMP table. So create view my view 2 as select employee number, employee name, comma salary. These are the 3 fields we are going to select for this view my view 2. So if you type select star from my view 2, you will see these 3 columns: employee number, employee name, and salary. So this is also a type of view which is called a simple view because it is created on single table. If you create a view on multiple tables, that view is called as complex view. There are other definitions of complex view also. Third question is also, we need to create a third view which is based on 2 tables actually. So that is the example of complex view. So how to create a complex view, that we are going to talk about, that we are going to see. So we have created a complex view named as my view 3 on 2 tables, EMP table and DPT table. So it is created like this, which is having 3 fields: employee number, employee name, and department name. So department name is a field from DPT table, and employee number and employee name are selected from EMP table. So the query is going to be like this: create view my view 3 as select employee number, employee name, comma department name from EMP comma DPT, where EMP.DPT number is equal to DPT.DPT number. As DPT number, that is department number column, is same in both the tables, that is employee table and DPT table. That's why we are putting that kind of condition here. So see, you can check department number column is there in both the tables. So see, it is saying query okay. Now type select star from my view 3. You will see these 3 fields: employee number, employee name, and department name. So it is called as complex view. We have created 2 simple views and third complex view. So next question: what happens to base table if you insert a record in a view? Find out the result. What we are going to see is, we are going to insert one record in view my view 1, and then we are going to see if there is any change in the base table EMP. What is base table? Base table is a table on which we have created views. So in our case, base table is EMP. So let us insert record in my view 1. We are going to insert values into these 3 fields. We already know how to insert the values. So insert into my view 1 employee number comma employee name comma cell values. So we are going to insert these values: employee number as 1000, name as Yogesh, and salary as 4000. So inserting the record into view is exactly the same as inserting the record into table. The syntax is going to remain same. So now we have inserted a record in view. Now we are going to see if there is any change in the base table, that is EMP table. So let us check that with this query, select star from EMP. So you can see, yes, it is there. A record with the employee name as Yogesh is inserted into base table after inserting the same record in view, simple view. So we can say that if we insert a record into a view, that same record can be inserted into, that same record will be inserted in base table. See, in my view 1, I have already have that record and which is inserted in base table. Next, what happens to the base table? What happens to the view if you insert the record into base table? That is the next question. So just reverse of the earlier, what we are going to do is we are going to insert one record into our base table, that is employee table, and then we are going to check what happens to the view, my view 1. Let us check that. So I am going to insert with employee ID 1001, name Sachin, and salary 5000. So it is inserted into base table EMP. Now check what happens to the simple view, my view 1. So see, here you can check same record is also inserted into my view 1. Okay, next one. What happens to base table if you delete a record from my view 1? Find out the result. So let us delete one record from the view and then check what happens to base table EMP. So delete from my view 1 where ename is equal to, for example, I want to delete employee name as Yogesh. I want to delete that particular record from view. So yes, it is deleted from view. That employee name Yogesh record is deleted from view. Now let us check what happens to the base table EMP. So see, it is also deleted from base table EMP. So we can conclude if you delete from base table, if you delete from view, from base table that record will be deleted. Next, reverse. Delete the record from the base table and then check what happens to view. So let us delete a record from the base table with employee name as Sachin and then check what happens to my view 1. So delete this record from EMP table with this particular query where employee name as Sachin. So it is deleted from base table EMP. Now check in view what happens in view. So it should also be deleted. So see, so we can conclude that either you delete or insert in base table, it will be affected to view, it will affect to view, and vice versa also true. Okay, now update the salary of employee of department number 20 to 4000 in my view 1 and observe the changes in base table. Now what happens if you fire update query on view? What happens to the base table? That's what we want to check. So let us say update set salary is equal to 4000 where department number equal to 20. So okay, I have forgot actually to write down the table name. Update view name, update my view 1. So set salary equal to 4000. Let us check what happens to the base table if I update in view. So this it is right. Now it is saying query okay. So I have updated salary of people of department number 20 to 4000 in view. Now let me check into my base table whether it has also affected base table or not. So select star from EMP. So here you can see in base table also it is affected. So the people who are in department 20, you can check their salary, it is 4000, it is updated to 4000. So you can conclude that either you do insert, update, delete to base table, it will affect to view, and vice versa also true. Next question, what happens to my view 1 if you alter base table employee by adding new column? Okay, now we want to check what happens to the view if you alter the base table. So that means if you run a DDL command like alter on base table, what happens to the view? That's what you want to check. So let us alter the base table by adding one column. So alter table EMP add column, for example the column name is new and we need to type the data type and its size. So I am adding a sample column called as new, with data type as integer and size as 10. So it is it will be added into the base table emp. Now let us check what happens to the view employee one view, my view one. So you can check there is no change in my view one. So you can conclude if you alter, you can conclude that if you alter in base table, there is no change in view. You can check it in select star from emp. This column is there, new column is there, but this column is not there in emp even after altering the base table. So that is the conclusion from the previous query. Next question, what happens to base table if you drop view? So if I drop the view, my view one, what will happen to base table? That's what we want to check. So drop is also a DDL command, that is data definition language. So for alter, we have seen there is no change. If you alter base table, there is no change in view. Let us check. Drop the view. If I drop the view, what happens to base table? Let me check. So select star from emp. So base table is as it is. It is as it is. There is no change in base table if even if I drop the view. So that's what we can conclude from that particular query. And then the last question. So we are going to drop. Let us check first of all, select star from my view 2. So we have a view called as 2, we have a view called as my view 2. In this you can check there are 3 columns, okay, and 13 rows. So if I check from my view 2 now, after dropping the table emp, you can say, you can check that there are no records. So what you can conclude is DDL command, if you fire it on base table and then fire it on, if you fire it on base table, there will be change into view, but not vice versa true. But for DDL command, it is true both the ways. Okay, so this is all about views and types of views, simple view and complex view. So that's it, friends. Thank you very much. I am going to provide that document in the description below this video. Thanks a lot.